It's always wonderful to come to Holly Springs. You know, this is the birthplace of Ida B. Wells, so I almost feel like I'm at home when I'm here. You know, my family, they were enslaved here. This is a special place for me to be, and definitely on MLK Day, because his principles stood for a lot of things that Ida B. Wells did. You know, they both stood for unity and just come together as one nation. So I am just honored to be here, and I feel the ancestors looking down on me today. And I think that on certain days, our ancestors would be proud at the way the world is coming. On other days, they would be ashamed that there's a lot of trivial things still going on, you know, present day, things that Dr. King fought for, you know, where he just wanted us to celebrate our differences and our commonalities. And that's something that we should do more of today. Okay, of course, I always knew who Ida B. Wells was. I was told about Ida B. Wells since I was a child, but I didn't understand who she was until I was a teenager. One day I read her autobiography, Crusader for Justice, and I fell in love with the fearless leader. It was amazing. I was like, wow, like I am related to her. She did such great things for our nation. You know, she wrote the job description for an investigative journalist before we knew what that was. You know, she was just ahead of her time, and I am proud and honored to have her DNA insanely helpful. It kind of makes me feel that I can do anything, right? Because Ida B. Wells wasn't just an extraordinary person. She was an ordinary woman from Holly Springs, Mississippi, who did extraordinary things. So it lets me know that I'm able to do the exact same thing. If I could say anything to Ida B. Wells today, I would ask her, is there still work left to do? Did she finish everything that she started? Is there something left for me to do? Well, she was ran out of Memphis. They burned down her newspaper office, and all we have today is a marker to remind us, you know, of her pain. But she proceeded to the discomfort, you know, which makes her extraordinary, where she had a price on her head, but she just kept going because she knew she had a story to tell.